Hello everyone, today we are going to do class 10 maths part 1 chapter number 1 linear equation in two variable practice set number 1.2. The other exercise is already been completed children. The link will be provided in the description box. In today's video we will be completing question 1 and question 2. Some questions from the question number 2 we will be completing. So let's start with the first question. Complete the following table to draw the graph of the equation. So these are the two equations that they have given. Okay, so this is the first equation and the second equation. For the first equation, we have to form such a table which has already been given in the textbook. You all have to only fill in the blanks. Okay, so how are you going to fill in the blanks? It's very easy. We have done this last year also. So what we have to take? We have to take this equation, that is x plus y is equal to 3. Okay, where x is equal to 3, already been given in the question. Okay, so what we have to do, only substitute the value of x in the equation, this equation. Okay, so 3 plus y is equal to 3, therefore y is equal to 3 minus 3, therefore y is equal to 0. Okay children, so what has we got as y? 0. So write 0, the answer is 3 and 0. Got it? Now for the second one, y has been given, but the equation should be the same. Don't change the equation, where y is equal to 5, already been given. Okay, so x plus 5 is equal to 3. Instead of y, we have placed 5. Therefore, x is equal to 3 minus 5. Therefore, x is equal to minus 2. Okay, so we have got our x variable, that is minus 2. So, minus 2 and 5. Got it? It's very easy. Now, the third one is x plus y is equal to 3. The same equation. Okay, now over here, again y is given, that is y is equal to 3. So, x plus 3 is equal to 3. Therefore, x is equal to 3 minus 3. Therefore, x is equal to 0. So, what is the value of x? 0. So, 0 and 3. Got it, children? So, in this way, you all have to fill in the blanks. Now, the next question, again, a different kind of a box has been given. It is to be solved, where only 2 is to be solved. The third one is already been solved. The same kind of equation as we solved for the first one. In the same pattern, we have to solve it. Okay, so x minus y is equal to 4, where y is equal to 0. You all have to substitute, isn't it? So x minus 0 is equal to 4. Therefore, x is equal to 4 plus 0. Therefore, x is equal to 4. Got it? This is 0. So, what we have got? 4 and 0. Got it, children? In this way, we have to solve it. The next one is x minus y is equal to 4. The same equation, but this time x is minus 1. So substitute the value, that is minus 1 instead of x, minus 1, minus y is equal to 4. Therefore, minus y is equal to 4 minus 1. When it moves to the left hand side or right hand side, it is going to change to plus 1. Therefore, y is equal to, we don't have to take minus children, okay, so y is equal to 5. In this way we have got our y variable, that is 5. So minus 1 and 5, and this has already been done. We have to only write in the x and y form. Got it? I hope this is clear. Now let's move to the next question. So next question is, solve the following simultaneous equation graphically. Okay, so what we have to do, we have to find our x and y variables for both the equations. That is why I have drawn two different blocks. Okay, and what we have to do, we have to first find what is x and y also. So first we have to see what is x and y. So x and y, okay, here we have to write both the variables together in order to plot the points. Now For the equation that is x plus y is equal to 6, first we have to change it. Okay, so change it means we have to form it in this way that y is equal to 6 minus x. Okay, so this is the equation that we have to form. Now, over here what we have to do, we can take x as any variable. Okay, so what we are going to do, we are going to take x as any variable. I am going to take 0, 2, 3, 4. Okay, take the smallest number and closest number. You all can take 1, 2, 3, 4, okay, or 0, 1, 2, 3. This also you all can take. Any, whatever you all want. Okay, but just don't take the bigger number or your graph might come wrong. Okay, take within 5. And you all have to only make 4 columns or maximum 3 columns. Not less than 3 columns you all have to make. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, we are going to do 4 columns. So using this equation, what we have to do, we are going to get our y very easily. So therefore, y is equal to 6 minus x, what we have taken, 0. Okay, so therefore y is equal to 6. Okay, so this is 6. Write it down. Again, y is equal to 6 minus, what is the value of x? 2. So y is equal to 4. Isn't it easy? So 4, that is 2 and 4. Next, y is equal to 6 minus x. Therefore, y is equal to 6 and x value is 3. So y is equal to 3. Y is equal to 6 minus x. Y is equal to 6 minus 4. Therefore, y is equal to 2 when you subtract it. So, 2. So, 4 and 2, we have got it. Is it clear, children? Wasn't it easy? Now, this has been done. Okay, for this equation, we have got our x and y variables. Okay, now we have to find for x minus y is equal to 4. So we will take this equation, that is x minus y is equal to 4. Okay, we will change it to minus y is equal to 4 minus x. Okay, so y's value, x value we have to substitute according to us. We are simultaneously going to get a y value. Okay, so again x and y. Okay, so now this time I am going to take x as 0, 1, 4, 5. Okay, you all can take any values for x. Now, same values you all have to substitute one by one in this equation. So, minus y is equal to 4. What is x that we have taken? It's 0. So, 4 minus 0 is going to be 4. Therefore, y is equal to minus 4. So, minus 4, 0 and minus 4. Same, again the equation is same, minus y is equal to 4 minus x. So minus y is equal to 4 minus 1, minus y is equal to 3, therefore y is equal to minus 3. Okay, so this is going to be minus 3. This is very easy, children. You all can do it on your own also. Take different number, try different numbers. Minus x. So minus y is equal to, this time its value is 4. So 4 minus 4 minus y is equal to 0. Therefore y is equal to 0. Okay, the subtraction sign we don't have to add it for 0. Now the next one is 5. Same equation, that is minus y is equal to 4 minus x. Minus y is equal to 4 minus 5. Therefore, minus y is equal to minus 1. Therefore, minus and minus is going to get reduced. Y we are going to get as 1. Okay. So, the answer is 1. 5 and 1. Now, we have got our x and y axis for both the equations. Okay. First and second. Now, why we have taken both different blocks and tables, children? Because we are going to get two separate lines where they are going to intersect. Okay, so where they are going to intersect, that we have to find by drawing the graph using this information. Okay, so first we will draw x plus y is equal to 6. This line we have to draw using these variables of x and y. Okay, so let's draw it. Okay, so the first table you all have to refer, children. The first table, first variable of x and y is 0 and 6. So 0 and 6. It's going to come over here. Mark the point 0 and 6. Okay, the next one was 2 and 4. So 2 and 4, it's coming over here. So 2 and 4. The next one is 3 and 3. So 3 and 3, it's over here. Okay, the other is 4 and 2. So 4 and 2, it's over here. Okay, so this is it. We will draw a line. Okay. Now, if our equation is right, if our calculations are right, you are going to get a straight line, children. Okay, so in this way, you will be getting a straight line for the equation x plus y is equal to 6. This was the equation of this line. Got it? Now, the second equation was x minus y is equal to 4. You all have to refer the second table for that. Okay? So, the first section was 0 and minus 4. So, 0 and minus 4, it's coming over here. 0 and minus 4. The next number was 1 and minus 3. So, 1 and minus 3, it's 1 and minus 3, it's coming over here. I hope it's visible to everyone. Okay. Now, the next one is 4 and 0. So, 4 and 0 means this. Okay. So, 4 and 0. Got it? Now, the third one is 5 and 1. So, 5 is over here. Where will 1 come now? See, 1 is going to come over here. It's not minus 1, children. It's plus 1. So, it's going to come over here. Got it? So, mark it over here. That is 5 and 1. Now, see, all the lines are coming in a straight. All the points are coming in a straight line. Yes, it is coming. Draw an equation. Draw a line of the equation x minus y is equal to 4. Okay? Now, what point of intersection you all have got? 5 and 1. So, that is what we have to write it. I hope, children, I haven't explained how to draw a graph. It's very much easy to draw a graph. X-axis, y-axis and the scale I have taken as 1 centimeter is equal to 1 unit on both the axes. I forgot to explain this. You all have to take 1 centimeter is equal to 1 unit on both the sides. Okay, same as we draw a normal graph. In the same way, we have to draw first quadrant, second quadrant, third quadrant, fourth quadrant. Okay, so after drawing a graph, I had already drawn it, so I forgot to explain it. But I hope everyone knows how to plot a graph. It's very easy. The difficult part was to how to draw the intersection lines, okay, of both the equations. Excuse me. Now you all have got the solution. Okay, so solution you all have to write on the next page. I am writing it over here only. The solution of the simultaneous equation is x, y, which is 5, 1. Isn't it? The intersection point you all have to find where both the lines intersect, and that is going to be your solution of the simultaneous equation. It's very easy. Now let's solve the second one. Now for the second one also same we have to do. Okay. So in this way x, y and both the variables are to be written together. We will change the first equation, that is x plus y is equal to 5. Keep y over here. Take 5 over there. It's going to be 5 minus x. Okay. Okay, so what you all have to take, what variables I am going to take for x, it is going to be 0, 3, 4, 5. Okay, children, is it clear to everyone? Okay, now, for the second equation, that is x minus y is equal to 3, So minus y is equal to 3 minus x. This is going to be the equation, and x variable that I'm going to take is going to be 1, 2, 3 and 5. Okay, you all can take any numbers of your wish. No matter, it won't matter. Just take smaller numbers so that the lines will come closer to each other. Okay, now once you all have taken x-axis, you all have to substitute in this equation. It's very easy. I have explained you in the first question. The same way, you all have to substitute one by one the values of x in this equation. This equation, you all have to substitute. You all are going to get your y-axis. So, I have got 5, 2, 1, 0. So, this is going to be the variable 5 and 0. Okay, now same x-axis I have taken, I am going to substitute the value of x in this equation. The numbers are going to come after solving this is going to be 1, minus 2, minus 1, 2, minus 1, 0, 3, 0, 2, 5 and 2. That's it. Is it clear, children? Now you all have got both the variables of the equation x and y. From the equation this, you all have got the x and y variables. You all have to plot the points using these numbers now. These variables you all have to use it. So the first equation was x plus y is equal to 5, and the first x and y that we have got from the table 1 was 0 and 5. So 0 and 5 will be coming over here, that is 0 and 5. Okay, next is 3 and 2. So 3 and 2 is coming over here, 3 and 2. 4 and 1, 4 and 1 is coming over here. Okay, 5 and 0. So where is 5 and 0 going to come? It's going to come over here. So 5 and 0. Draw the line. Children, if you all are not able to find the equation, the answer for the x or y axis, you all are not able to find, let me know in the comment section. Okay, so this was which equation? X plus y is equal to 5. Okay, so this line we have got it. Now the second line is 1 and minus 2. You all have to refer table number 2. That is 1 and minus 2. 1 and minus 2, it's over here. 1 minus 2. The next is 2 and minus 1. So 2 and minus 1, it's over here. The next one is 3 and 0. So it is going to come over here. And the other last one is 5 and 2. So 5 and 2, it's going to come over here. Okay, so this point I forgot to mark. Okay, now in this manner draw a straight line. I hope it's visible, children. Okay, so the point of intersection is 4 and 1, so that is going to be your solution. Okay, it's clear. Yeah, it's clear now. Okay, so therefore the solution of the given simultaneous equation is x, y, which is 4 and 1. Okay, so this was a point of intersection that only we have written. Now the next sum I will be solving in tomorrow's video, children, as the video is getting too lengthy. I hope you all have understood till here. Practice this sum and let me know in the comment section if there is any problem. Again, I forgot to mention how to draw the graph, but it's the same, the basic graph as we plot in the same way. X-axis, y-axis, scale I have already taken, you all can read it. Okay, so I don't think there is anything to explain how to draw a graph, because from 6th standard we have been drawing all these graphs. Okay, the different part is that we have to show the intersection lines using the given equation. So let's end the video over here. See you in the next video. I will be posting it tomorrow. So see you in the next video. Till then, take care. Bye.